determines an element and identifies or determines the nature of something or that exists or conditions in another one. Now we have solved our question. Now we have multiplied 4 into 5 minus 2 into 8.
Today we are going to find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. To find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, we are given this example 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 0, 2, 3, 1. To find the determinant, first we should multiply the first element with the excluding numbers that comes in the row and column of the first element. That is 1, 0, 3, 1. 1, 0, 3, 1. Then subtract from the second element multiplied by the excluding element that comes in the row of the second element. That is 4, 0, 2, 1. That is 4021. Then add it to the third element and excluding numbers, that is 4123. Then we should do the determinant for this one, and this one. Then multiply with the respective numbers. After doing that, we will get 1 minus 8 plus 30, that which is equal to 23. This is how we do determinant for 3x3 matrix.
Determinants is used to find the area of the triangle and it is used to solve complex linear equations that has more than two variables.
Today we learned how to find the inverse of a matrix. For this video, we find out the next one. That is 1, 3, 2, and 5. So we will keep this matrix on the left hand side and we should identify the matrix on the right hand side. So that we can find the inverse of the matrix. So the main objective is to convert this 1, 3, 2, 5 into 1, 0. 0, 1. Now we use some power questions to convert this 1325 into 1001. Now, as the first element in the first row is 1, we don't need to apply any row operations. So we go to the second row, that is 2. We convert the 2 into 0 by using the row operations. And so we go. Now we jump into the next row operations, that is r2 is equal to r2 into minus 1. And we convert the minus 1 over here to 1 by using these row operations. And after doing that, we go to the third operation. That is R1 is equal to R1 minus 3 R2. By doing this, we will convert the 3 over here to into 0 so that we get an inverse of A. That is minus 5, 3, 2, and minus 1.
The applications of Gauss-Jordan methods are it helps in solving complex linear problems.